Hello everybody, today I'm Nimisha Akumar from Basil Mind. I'm here to talk to you about psychological well-being in the COVID era. So the coronavirus or the COV is a virus genus that is thought to be one of the world's most dangerous pathogens today. The deadly virus that emerged in 2019 has taken over 3.2 million lives worldwide in just 16 months, affecting everyone and anything in its path. COVID-19 is caused by a novel coronavirus known as Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus 2 or SARS-CoV-2 that causes serious respiratory illnesses. COVID-19 caused millions of deaths worldwide, with India accounting for over 278,000 deaths, not only impacting everyone's physical health but also jeopardizing their mental being. One of the most common problems encountered during the pandemic was poor mental health. Anxiety and depressive symptoms were found to be 3 to 4 times more severe, as was a trauma and stressor related condition, or also called TSRD. And this was due to COVID-19, and this escalated substance abuse. Suicidal ideation was more than twice as widespread, and an overall increase in the rates of negative mental health, as well as an increased number of sexual and physical violence cases was noted. Alternatively, there were signs referring to a surge in the number of people searching for anxiety-related words on the internet and the number of people calling panic or suicide hotlines. The ones affected by the virus recorded feelings of loneliness, boredom, and dissatisfaction as a result of their isolation. Fears of death and the possibility of being held responsible for the virus's spread among family members and acquaintances grew rapidly. Taking all of these factors into consideration, we can categorize a few groups that are at high risk, and these include young people, critical job holders, unpaid nurses for adults, and those with pre-existing medical disorders have reported having risen negative emotional and behavioral health symptoms. Depression symptoms were also found in those with lower income levels. This pandemic has been a reflection of systemic abuse, in which social and socio-political forces have limited marginalized people's powers. In comparison to other working respondents, critical care employees like doctors, nurses, and all the frontline workers have had poorer mental and physical health issues. Suicidal ideation was seen in about 1/4 of people with anxiety and depressive disorders. There are a lot of ways that one can deal with this sort of psychological distress, and this requires a variety of approaches, like community and workplace initiatives to improve social and economic support, to minimize the financial burden and encourage social connectedness. And this should be included in prevention efforts. This will give out the promotion of safe habits such as adequate daily sleep and exercise. Stressors which include home confinement and social isolation will continue to exist, but this does not mean that we cannot give ourselves the rest that we deserve. Signs and symptoms of poor mental health should be monitored on a regular, frequent, and widespread basis. Many people have turned to telemental and telebehavioral health to provide behavioral counseling or psychotherapy online as a result of the mental and behavioral health epidemic. A substantial reduction in psychiatric hospitalizations have been linked to this crisis. Communities, employers, and public health communicators must work together to ensure that these services are properly funded and that people are aware of the national resources for mental and behavioral health. Now that we know all of this, now comes the time when we need to seek mental assistance and support. And that is where we at Basil Mind come into picture. At Basil Mind, we promote and provide integrative mental health care and holistic wellness for issues ranging from general anxiety or to what we now call COVID anxiety. We hope you receive the help you need and live a stress-free life. Thank you.